Hello everyone, today we will learn a new chapter in history, that is chapter number 6, the revolt of 1857. You all are aware that we were enslaved by the British and we have fought, we have got our freedom, but when did the struggle for freedom started? Do you know this? So let me tell you. The mighty uprising of 1857 was the first great and direct threat to the British rule in India, which shook the very foundation of British Empire. British historians are of the view that it was a mutiny of sepoys, while many Indian historians describe the revolt as the first war of independence. So you might be understand by this that in the year 1857, we had fought our first war of independence. There were many causes of the revolt. They are political, economic, socio-religious and military. And there was an immediate cause as well. In year 1856, the army introduced a new rifle, the Enfield rifle, which had a greased paper wrapped around the cartridge. The sepoy had to bite off the paper to load it into the rifle. The rumor was that the new cartridges were greased with the fat of cows and pigs. It created an offensive feeling among the Hindus and the Muslims. As you know that the Hindus worshipped cows and the Muslims detested pigs. They refused to use new rifles as this hurt their religious sentiments. Many historians also believe in this story and feel it was a deliberate move to hurt Indian sentiments. Introduction of cartridges greased with the fats of cows and pigs became the immediate cause behind the outbreak of the revolt. The main centers of the revolt were Delhi, Meerut, Kanpur, Lucknow, Jhansi, Banaras and other parts of Bihar. The main cause behind the failure of revolt was that the revolutionary did not have a unified command and were unable to organize a united front. The people did not gather together and couldn't fight against the British unitedly. This shows the suppression of the revolt. Rani Lakshmi Bai, Tatya Tope, Kuwar Singh, Bhakt Khan all died in the battlefield while Nana Sahib and Begum Hazrat Mahal escaped to Nepal. By the end of 1859, the British restored their rule and order. For them, it was as good as reconquest of India. Now let's talk about the causes of the failure of revolt. The first and the foremost cause is that there was no unified command of the revolutionaries. Large parts of western and southern India remained unaffected. Many sections of Indian population were with British. This was the worst reason of the failure. The upper class, the modern educated class and the propertied class were critical of rebels, means they do not support them. Lack of modern weapons and equipment was also a cause of failure. Poor organization and lack of coordination among the states and the revolutionaries made this revolt a failure. And what were the effects of the revolt? Let's just find out. The long period of misrule by East India Company came to an end and the administration was taken over by the British Crown. Queen Victoria was proclaimed the Empress of India. The Board of Control and Board of Directors were replaced by the Secretary of State for Indian Affairs. The rule of the Mughals and Peshwas came to an end. The Queen's Proclamation of 1858 assured Indian princes that there would be no more annexation of territories. Their rights of adoption were also accepted. According to this proclamation, more educated Indians got the chance to associate themselves with the administration of the country the need of cooperation with the Indians was fully realized. The army was reorganized to prevent further such revolts. The proclamation also granted general pardon to all except those found guilty of murdering the British. One more effect had come to place, that is, the Governor General was given the title of Viceroy and was subordinated to the Secretary of the State. The revolt of 1857 was one of the major landmarks in the history of India. The heroic struggle served as a constant source of inspiration. Indians' perception of themselves and their country was to change the history of India forever, and just because of that, we got our freedom in 1947. So that's all for this chapter. I hope you don't have any doubt in this chapter. Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section below or through the Campus Square app. Thank you, students.